everybody. This is Tippy.
And this is Jo.
And you're listening to the Tippy Jo Show, sponsored by BetterHelp.com/the barn. If it's all right. Listening to the Tippy.
Oh, I was getting ready to say, you ain't starting off how you usually say. It's like, hey, welcome everybody.
We've got some guests in the studio with us today, though, here in the barn studio.
Yep.
We've got Tom and Julie of the Lunch Lady Food Truck. Say hi.
How's it going, everybody?
Hello.
Glad to have you guys here today. We've got a lot of cool things to talk about. I hear Joe has got some interesting theories this evening, which I'm super excited to talk about. But before we get into that, I think we should talk a little bit about our guests. So Tom and Julie own the Lunch Lady Food Truck. Tell me about that, guys.
Well, we started out in October of 2019.
Nice. Been doing it for a minute then, huh?
A little bit. We're into year four doing it. We have burgers, chicken sandwiches, pulled pork, 5 different kinds of tacos, weekly specials, sometimes daily specials. Pretty well state, St. Francis County, a little bit of Washington County, a little bit of St. Jen.
But hands down, best burger I've ever had in my entire life.
Thank you very much.
Yes. This man knows how to do extra pickles, by the way.
Yes, for sure. If somebody wants extra, they don't want 3 extra pickles.
That's right. I want all of the pickles.
A 4-inch stack of pickles on a burger.
That's the best part ever. Yes.
I've never heard a complaint.
Never. Not never. One time.
You actually offered my mom a meal for her birthday. She didn't come get it, and I bitched her out for it. But I think she was in Save-A-Lot somewhere, and I think she was complaining that her kids weren't taking her to lunch that day.
Aww.
And you had told her, come up to the truck, and I'll get you a meal.
Oh, that's so sweet.
I was like, that's...
You can't tell people I do that. Now they're all going to they get free meals.
Don't tell Tom it's your birthday. That's so okay, funny. That's because he tried to do one kind deed for a little old lady.
That's definitely an important
my
little
mom's
tidbit,
not a little
though.
Old lady. I better
and
take
I
that back.
Love that. Yeah, she's going to listen to this and be like, what? No, but I think that's an important little tidbit to throw out there because it just shows their character. Like, these two people are some of the best people I know. I love them with my whole heart, but they're just fantastic people.
We like to put money in good people's pockets.
Absolutely. Support small. Shop small. All the time. So you know what is a small business? A food truck, by the way.
Yes.
A lot of people don't connect that.
The smallest of small
businesses. The smallest of small businesses. Traveling small business.
What was the drive?
I wanted to open up a restaurant, and I was in her ear like every day for like 5 years going, hey, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. And she finally said, what'd you say?
I said, let's compromise through a food truck.
Yeah, said, hey, let's do a food truck. And I'm like, okay, fine. She thought I was going to say no to that. So, yeah, and then we just did it. I had an opportunity to get out of Walmart that I was with for almost 15 years to take some money to leave. So, did it, bought that truck, and just went for it.
Yeah. Beautiful story.
What? Well, I like the mobility the freedom. I think you probably get more from working a food truck than being stuck in a restaurant.
Absolutely.
Every day at the same place.
Yeah, absolutely.
I assume that's really nice.
If we had a brick and mortar and we're like, hey, we're going to close early, or hey, we're just going to work 2 days this week and have that kind of offset schedule, you know, it doesn't work. People get mad
people,
at that.
People wouldn't come then.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. So we just took like random Thursdays off throughout the school year to go hang out with the grandbabies at their school and stuff. So
that's awesome.
You can't do that if you have a brick and mortar with a set schedule.
Yeah, that's true.
Yes.
But if you don't put your schedule on the door, then you don't have a set schedule. That's how I do it. That way people can't bitch and say, you're supposed to be open. I'm like, tell me where it says that.
Online.
Online.
Over Facebook,
yeah. When I'm
not on the door,
like, you're open the door.
Bitch, that thing lies.
Yeah. Funny.
It doesn't have to be on the door. You have hours
posted. Well, the hours posted won't change. So that's out of my control. I have tried to change my hours on Facebook like 752 times because I'm not open until 6 on Fridays. It will not. It'll tell me it changed. It stays the same. So I don't know what the fuck to do. So it's whatever. It's cool.
I don't even know if we have anything on there. I don't even know that I've ever looked.
I think I set it up even before we opened on what we thought we were going to do.
Yeah. Yeah, you're going to have to grab that mic when you're talking. Ooh. There, baby. Grab it
like this?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh, that was the last episode. Calm your tits.
Is that the hot dogs?
Hot dogs, and more hot dogs. I was fond of that episode. I do love a gas station hot dog, whatever. Let's not get me started on that.
So, Julie, what eventually made you decide, hey, let's give this a shot? Were you just tired of Tom every day?
Yeah, sure. I don't know. I just thought we should just try it because I was tired of what I was doing. Mm. I'd done it for the last 30 years of my life.
Mm-hmm.
So I knew I could go and serve people on a truck. And he wanted away from the store. So
nice.
Like, yeah, let's do that. And we could hang out with the babies and make our own schedule, like he said. So here we are. We get to hang out with you guys tonight because we can make our own schedule.
That's right. See? Lots of opportunities when you make your own schedule. What made you pick the food choice? Like, is that like something you just have done, like experience, family?
Oh, some of it. Actually, a lot of it. Like, I probably in my head wanted to do stuff fancier, but, you know, I mean, I'm not knocking it, but the newer we're at, like, people want pulled pork, they want burgers, they want, you know, that's just kind of what,
you gotta know your market.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Just gotta know your market. Trying to do, like, you know, fancy stuff just wouldn't have gone over as well.
That makes sense. I really like it when you do your tamales.
Oh, my God.
Yes. Yes.
Everybody loves when you do tamales.
It's crazy. That's like the special that people are the most cutthroat crazy about. It's awesome.
So how far ahead do you plan your menu? Like, do you know? So this upcoming week you have tamales. Do you know what's the following week?
Sometimes I'll know ahead of time.
Well, because when this episode comes out, tamales will be over.
Yes.
It'll be the next week that we'll be going into.
It'll be like 2 weeks, right?
No. Yeah. So
this will come out next Friday.
Yeah. So we'll be the end of your tamale week. So when they listen to it, they'll be thinking about this upcoming week that you'll be out. So if that makes sense, like not
next week,
Monday
even,
through Friday.
Week,
next
yeah, 2 weeks, like you
week.
Said, pretty much.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I don't know that far out ever.
Yeah. He's like, no.
I could guess.
You can make some shit up if you wanted to sell it.
But get yourself on Facebook, look up the Lunch Lady Food Truck, and then you will have all of his schedules, where he's going to be, what they going to cook.
Very, very true.
I got a question. Yes. How'd you come up with the Lunch Lady?
We went through, she was just rattling off names and said a couple. Like, one, she was like, ooh, say by the smell. I'm like, that screeches porno. We can't. That's a terrible idea.
Oh, that's great.
That's a great idea, but that would, no.
But how many people would really know that?
You know, it only takes one.
That's true.
And I, like I said, I looked at it and I found out. So I was like, nope. And honestly, she said the Lunch Lady. I'm like, well, that is it. So my grandma and my mom's oldest sister were Lunch Ladies. My grandma's a huge influence on everything I do. And then, of course, like Farley. Chris Farley is my absolute favorite. He's like a personal hero. He's just the funniest dude that's ever lived.
I think the nostalgia of that on your truck is what a lot of people went, yeah, go there now.
Right.
Oh, yeah. And then, you know, our it's on the table slogan. That's what my grandma would say. You know, if we had like a dinner or anything at her house. It was like, it's on the table. That's when everybody knew to come to eat.
And you got a new burger on your menu, and it's called?
Well, it's not on the menu. It's off the menu.
Okay.
But anybody hearing this, you can get it anytime. It's called the Steve?
Question mark.
Yeah, it's a secret menu item.
Yes. So, since, she was like 2 years old, anytime me and Zoe, our granddaughter, who's five now, if we saw somebody on TV and we're like, hey, what's his name? We'd just go, I don't know, Steve? Right? It's just a little inside joke that her and I have had for, you know, 3 years now. I was telling her what's on this burger. I'm like, what should we call it? She goes, I don't know, Steve.
That's too cute.
I'm like, yep, okay, that's it. It sticks. Perfect. I love it.
It is great. That's so cute. That is so cute. What Smart. Is on the Steve?
Okay, on the Steve? Okay, so spicy mayo, raw onions, a slice of American cheese, a slice of pepper jack cheese, diced fresh jalapenos, grilled to get a little char on them, and then honey drizzle.
Oh my God.
Right. If you'd have told me that honey on a cheeseburger would be good, I would have laughed at you. But it's delicious.
It sounds incredible.
It's just stupid. Like, we eat that burger more than I really want to admit. A lot.
I mean, I don't blame you. I love fresh jalapenos on a burger. My God. So good. That crunch.
Yeah, yeah. That's the heat is cool and the jalapenos are cool, but the getting the crunch of the fresh jalapeno, oh, it's delicious.
I'm a texture person all the way.
Absolutely.
Ooh, that texture. Love it. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll be talking with Tom and Julie from the Lunch Lady Food Truck.
Thank you to BetterHelp for sponsoring this episode. BetterHelp is the world's largest therapy service, and it's 100% online. With BetterHelp, you can tap into networks over 30,000 licensed and experienced therapists who can help you with a wide range of issues. To get started, you just answer a few questions about your needs and preferences in therapy. That way, BetterHelp can match you with the right therapist from their network. Then you can talk to your therapist however you feel comfortable, whether it is via text, chat, phone, or video call. You can message your therapist at any time and schedule live sessions when it is convenient for you. If your therapist isn't the right fit for any reason, you can switch to a therapist at no additional charge. With BetterHelp, you get the same professionalism and quality you expect from an in-office therapist, but with a therapist who is custom-picked for you, more scheduling flexibility, and at a more affordable price. Get 10% off your first month at BetterHelp.com/thebarn. That's better, HELP.com/thebarn.
This episode is brought to you by Copper Fox Contrived, located at 361 West Main Street, Park Hills, Missouri. Handmade gifts and wood flowers.
Hey, I saw you guys recently. Kyle and I hit the streets. We were at Park Hills Underground. Saw you guys at the costume concert series. That was a lot of fun.
I love that place.
Yeah?
Yes, absolutely.
Did you like our costumes?
Oh, they were great. They weren't dressed up.
Oh, I was going to say, what were they? I didn't see the pictures.
They were not in costume.
Yeah, she wasn't happy.
Well, actually, Tom was a golf person because he was wearing a golf polo.
No, what was that guy's name? It was a professional golfer that withdrew from the tournament right before the tournament started. I only played the practice rounds because I had shorts and an untucked polo.
Very specific. That's very specific. Yes. I love it.
We did have somebody there tell us that we... they thought we were dressed up as the McCloskeys, the lawyer.
Oh yeah, you did look funny. Like that.
Yeah,
that's legit.
That was the most like my feelings have ever been hurt.
That's so funny. Well, maybe don't dress like that,
right?
Huh?
I backhanded that guy just out of instinct. I didn't even mean to do it.
Yeah. So you guys go down to the Underground a lot?
Yeah. Usually, you know, we're going down for like open mic night and karaoke night.
Yeah.
With our good friend, Christy.
Yeah, which is every Thursday. They have open mic, and then afterwards is karaoke with karaoke queen, Christy.
And then the last couple weeks, we've been going down and just watching some of the original shows, and it's just, it's so fun. It's, you know, it's completely different than anything else around here. Just
for sure.
Music-wise, atmosphere-wise, it's awesome.
I think it's so refreshing to go and listen to music and it's not the same stuff that you hear every single place in town over and over and over. Like, don't get me wrong. I love a local artist and I love all of the singers that we have. They're all fantastic, very talented people, but it does get a little old to hear the same songs over and over and over.
Yes, very much so. Then to go down and, you know, a lot of these bands are essentially their kids. They're, you know, late teens and early 20s.
Getting started.
Yeah, just starting out in bands and going and having a good time and getting to hear original music out of them is just, it's awesome.
It's so cool what they're doing too, because we don't have a place before the Underground. We didn't have a place where new bands just starting up could go and they could play their music, their original music, and just be there, you know, just be appreciated, you know, like no place does that. So I think that's so cool that they're allowing all these fresh new bands, all these kids to really just kind of live out their dreams.
Absolutely.
So neat. I love it so much.
The first time I walked in there, it was Rust Belt playing, and I don't remember what song, but it was like a 90s alternative song, and my head just started bobbing.
Yeah.
And it hasn't stopped from when I hit those doors, like till I walk out. It's awesome.
I love it so much.
Every time we go in there, I say it's like being back in high school, because like whenever I was in high school, the band scene was big. Like everybody was in a band. So it's cool to kind of go in there, see those kids doing what they're doing, and it just kind of takes me back.
Yeah.
Absolutely. It's just that it's the most nostalgic place that I hang out, for sure.
It really just like I know it's kind of silly, it's kind of soppy, but it like warms your heart, you know, just to see like these kids like doing their own thing. I just think that's so cool that they have that opportunity. I just love it. I love it.
And
it's just the neatest place.
Their parents are always there cheering them on too. It's like, I know, it's so heartwarming. Cute. It's the most wholesome place that, really that I go is. To as well.
And the staff, my God, you know who I love so much?
Tommy.
Oh my gosh, he's the best.
He is
just
the nicest guy.
Sweetest man I've ever met in my entire life.
Yep.
Like, I go there usually on Thursdays after we record the show. I usually go down there and hang out for a bit so we can do karaoke. And every time I walk in, he's already got, I like tahine on my beer because I'm a weirdo. He's already got it sitting on the counter waiting for me. And I just think that's just so sweet. And it's not even like I was a frequent flyer there and then he realized what I needed. It was like, no, time two I was there, he was like, hey, this is for you. And I was like, dang, like that made me come back actually. Because, like, they cared enough about me, a random stranger, to just want to do that for me. You know? That's so cool. I love it.
Those little personal touches.
Yes.
Make a place great, for sure.
Oh, absolutely. I think that's great.
Yeah. Cool place.
Yeah. Well, cool.
I like that they do the comedy thing there. Like, I think that's fun.
Oh, actually, that's tonight, though. Well, I mean, we're living in the future, so y'all are going to miss it. Oh. But tonight, actually, is their comedy roast battle.
Yeah, roast battle.
Yeah. Which is really cool. That's cool that they're doing those things. And soon they've got Afro Man coming. Did you see that?
July 8th. Oh,
yes.
I did see that.
How neat is that?
It's awesome. It's not only Afro Man, like a giant cannabis festival.
Yes.
In downtown Park Hills.
I'm so stoked to go to that. That's going to be the neatest thing ever. Like our small town. Who would have guessed it, you know? Just so neat. I love it.
All right. I've sold the concert out. And yeah, they're looking to bring like 2,000 people to town is what they're guessing.
Oh my gosh. And you got to get special tickets though to hang out in the tent, right?
I think the tent is like $25 or 25. 21 and up.
Yep. Oh, that's
just
not
to go
bad.
Down and hang out and listen to the bands they have outside,
just
you know,
jamming.
Beforehand, just jamming and, you know, food trucks, vendors.
Oh, I love it. Are you guys going to be set up there?
Absolutely.
Oh, cool.
It's a weed festival. It's like shooting fish and
yeah. So I can get real stoned and come get my favorite burger, extra pickles.
Sure.
I love that. Joe, have you been down there yet?
I went to the opening.
Yeah, a couple times you've been there, huh?
Good times. I bought a Breezy Point shirt.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
I support the children.
So I support the children.
With my cash.
Absolutely. Oh, gosh. What you got on the docket today there, Joe? I know you got some stuff you wanted to tell me about.
Well, not
today.
Really. Just amazing things that I find that I didn't know.
I love your little tidbits of information, though. You bring the best.
Well, I'm on YouTube a lot, and there's always, like, random, like, you know, we alien, like top 10 things, top 20 things. Well, this one was like conspiracies, like about the planet.
Yeah.
And some of them I almost remembered.
Oh, she's a flat earther, guys.
That's what I
know.
I'm just kidding.
No, it doesn't involve a flat earth or a turtle.
No, the other day, Joe was like, I want to talk about some conspiracies. And I was like, what are they? And she's like, well, I'm not going to tell you because then you'll know about them. And I was like, well, she's like, they're about the earth, though. And I was like, you're talking about flat earth? So I said the same thing.
No.
Like, no.
Well, this one kind of reminded me of like your little quantum.
Oh, thing. Okay.
Okay. And I kind of remember it. And you guys probably all jog it whenever scientists a few years back, according to this, in 2012, they like made a black hole. They called it like the God particle and they made a black hole and the world kind of freaked out. Like, is it going to grow? Is it going to absorb the whole planet?
Yeah, I do recall that slightly.
Well, apparently, there is a theory that the European Organization for Nuclear Research is at the heart of a crazy conspiracy theorist because it includes the beliefs that when the CERN discovered the Higgs, whatever, aka the God particle.
Sure, big words.
Yeah, big words. You're not next to me to read the big words. Inadvertently created a black hole.
That's fucking wild.
Right. But we were already sucked into it.
That's
like
the
moment it was created, we were sucked into that black hole.
Dang.
And now we're like in a black hole.
Living
But does that even matter?
Well, I try to think back to like 2012 and I'm like, has anything changed? And then it flips to like you also, the Mandela effect.
Yes. Mm. That's a big, big thing. So with the Mandela effect, Mandela. I was like, is it Mandela? No, it's definitely Mandela. But the theory is with that one. So there's a lot of theories, obviously, that stem off of that. But basically, the Mandela effect is that we all collectively have these memories. Some of us do, some of us don't. So like half the population is like, no, it's the Berenstain Bears, and the other half is are like, no, it's the Berenstain Bears. So a lot of people are like, well, how can so many people remember it this way and so many people remember it that way? It doesn't make any sense. Well, the theory is, one of the theories, is that we actually died.
Or apparently went through a black hole.
Yes.
And the dimension shifted. Right.
So one theory is that we all died together and now we're in an alternate timeline. And those other people that remember it to be the different way than we do, we're already in this timeline. So when we come in, we're carrying our memories from the past life. It's wild.
And then I believe Stephen Hawking just came out with, now he believes you are actually transported through particles through a black hole.
Yes.
Oh. Not like disassembled.
I don't think he just came out with that because he's been dead for a minute.
Yeah, that is true,
though. No, he hasn't.
Maybe.
Allegedly.
From beyond the grave, he's...
Hang on. Is there another one that I'm thinking of?
Well, it could
you're talking
been...
about Jason Hawking, his brother.
No.
He's not nearly as
Stop.
Smart.
Stop.
No, you're going to break my heart right now. But when? I mean, it could have been something I was watching that didn't say he said it now, but based
right.
on his theories.
Mm. Yes.
I mean, they're going to pick through all of his shit now.
Oh. So here's a question. So is
Such
it?
Did you see
one?
What they
I
did to
it.
SpongeBob as soon as the creator was gone? Boom, boom, boom.
What'd they do? What do you mean?
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
Movie spinoffs.
Oh yes,
like different
okay,
animation.
So he was probably like, "This is the way I want to do it." And after he died, they were like, "It's a free for all. Let's fucking
Let's make
they can
some
run
money.
With it.
What's their you. Business, not mine."
So the best that they got in those alternate universes was Berenstain Bears and Berenstain.
Exactly.
No, there's so
Curious
much more.
George doesn't
you changed
have a
my
tail.
Coke to Pepsi.
Does Curious George have a tail?
2018.
Good God.
Oh yeah, I told
yeah,
you.
Yeah, he died a while ago. Yeah.
But I mean, maybe he.
Maybe not in your universe. Whatever
hole.
I watched said that he had a theory that that's what it. Okay.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying. Someone else can Google it. Look it up. That's what the point
well,
of this
we
show
don't have
is.
A Google guy
for
nothing, right?
He ain't Googling no more.
I know.
He quit
what
Googling
fuck?
Last
okay.
week.
At this point, I've just... it's clear that this whole show is made up. Nothing is fact. There's no reason for me to Google anything. Anybody listening to this, just assume it's bullshit.
Disclaimer, we know nothing.
Let me remember, I'm not live
nothing
and I can take my time.
Oh, gosh.
I don't know, but that just like kind of blew my mind just a little bit.
So that is crazy, but the thing is, like, apparently it didn't affect us that we can tell. So,
well, I don't think it happened.
I don't think it happened.
No, I don't think we got sucked into it. That surprises you?
That does surprise me a little bit.
I think, would there be any sort of sign of it? Like, wouldn't we see something happening?
Well, maybe.
Or if unless it just sucked in the whole universe all at once and nothing.
We can sleep through a lot.
Yeah. But the thing is, like, while we're sleeping, other people are awake. So if it happened, somebody would have seen it.
That's a good point. So you remember when everybody was freaking out that the world was going to end in 2012 and then again in 2020 and then again, you know, like,
I thought she was
always
talking about year 2000, but
yeah,
then
me
I remember.
Too. I was like, why well, all of them? Yeah. All of them. Yeah. But no, so they said, you know, like, 2012, the Mayan calendar said that the world was going to end. But I was young in 2012, obviously. And here I am thinking, well, if the world's going to end, isn't China going to tell us first? Because it's tomorrow already. Like, that was my thought process as a kid. Like, it will have already happened to them because they had, like, a date.
But then
and,
you
like,
got to remember, time is just a concept.
That's right. It's all made up. Everything's made up. Life isn't real. Do what you want.
Except for the lunch lady food truck. That's
real. Yeah, that's real as shit.
Very real.
Or is it?
Oh, gosh.
You guys can... whenever, like, don't be afraid to just jump in, chime in.
Oh no, it's super easy with you talking.
No, stop.
I'm just kidding.
We've told her that before.
Listen, sometimes when we edit the podcast, I'd be getting real stoned, and when I listen to it, when
always
I'm stoned,
when we edit the podcast,
that's
you'd
true.
Be getting real stoned.
But when I'm stoned and I listen to it, I think, oh my god, I talk so much. I need to shut the fuck up. And then I get like really hard on myself and I'm like, I hate this episode. This is terrible. We shouldn't release this. But then when I listen to it, not Stony Baloney, then I'm like, oh my god, this is so funny and we're all fantastic. Let's do it again.
I don't know that I'll be able to listen to my own voice.
Well, you're going to have to.
Probably, but you know.
I think you'll be pleasantly surprised.
I had a hard time. Like, I could never listen to myself sing or anything like that. And then I think it was probably Keith that sent a video.
Yeah.
at the Underground of me and Christy singing Don't Let Me Down. And I thought, oh my gosh, that sounds great.
You are a fantastic singer. Yeah, I love doing karaoke with you. You're my favorite karaoke partner.
Other than Kyle.
What the fuck? That was an afterthought, though.
Like, don't worry. You're just there to have fun. And don't, no one cares. Like, we are all awesome, epic singers. Yeah. Get up there and they're like, we don't know her. Yeah. We don't know her.
Ever.
One night we were all in the bar and somebody, this man came up to me and was like, I just want to let you know you're the best singer here. But I was sitting at a table with all these people. I was like, this motherfucker just trying to get in my pants.
Yeah. Right, yep. It was hitting on you. That's awesome.
Sweet. Hey, quick shout out though. Keith is fantastic. He's always recording us when we're singing, always taking the best pictures, always sending them out. He's a very kind and caring friend down there. I think that's great.
Our whole circle is just literally the nicest, most uplifting, wonderful people that I've ever been around. It's awesome.
You know, I talk a lot about surrounding yourself with the type of people that you want to be, and I feel like we've really created a great group. Just like a great group of people who are all just like kind-hearted people, very uplifting, very positive, and I love that. Absolutely. Very driven, successful, very driven people.
Yep. It all starts with her for me.
Aww.
Without her, I'm an asshole.
Without who? I don't hear anybody else here.
Without Julie.
He won't let me talk.
See? Talking about me, it's all you.
I know. It's going to be tough for anybody with the two of us loud mouths here.
That's true.
Julie, you can share with me.
I'm fine being quiet.
Nah. Oh, gosh. You want the people to get to know you, Julie?
Not really.
She's like, I see these people almost every day.
I think that's a funny dynamic because, like, Tom and Tippy here, they're very go out and talk to people, whereas Julie and I are very like, leave me the fuck alone. I just want to chill. So I think that's always funny.
I feel like that's almost the same dynamic in every couple that we even know. There's always one.
Except that it's bullshit for both of them because they say they're like
that's
that
true.
Until they get around people and then they're like, hey, everybody! Right? Like both of them. They're both just as good at it as we are. They just, you know.
That just means we're more uncomfortable. So we just throw ourselves out there obnoxiously to get it over with.
Absolutely.
We're free.
It's one of those, talk to them before they try to talk to me.
Oh, is that what you do?
At least then I can steer the conversation.
I'm going to force them to like me.
Yeah, she always says that, but was it 3 weeks ago when we walked into the Underground and she walked in and like the whole place popped? What? Hey, Judy's here!
Oh my God, it's Judy!
It was one person. It was
I do love me some Julie. I always do get excited when you show up. You're a little homebody, you little hermit. It's always nice to see you out of your little shell.
Yeah, occasionally I will.
Yeah.
Tom lets me out of my cage.
Right.
He keeping you locked down. I mean, I understand why, but, you know.
Gosh.
What else? You had another one, Joe. Did you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
I don't know. I thought we flowed well with the other one. We would just leave it at that.
Well, I mean.
Because we spurred into what? Well, you all know The Journey to the Center of the Earth, right?
Yeah.
The old movie. There's actually a scientific theory on that being true.
Hmm. Like, that there's a whole other world down there?
Yeah, like that there's actually a planet at the Earth's core.
Well, then, like, we've never been to the Earth's core, so really, it's
exactly.
All.
Exactly. So how fucking far? Know. And that's it. That's the theory. And I was just like, you know, that dates back far. Because I'm trying to. Let me look it up. Continue talking.
Or not.
It'll be cut. It don't matter. Well, I'm trying to think. When was that book written?
Long.
You know, that's like an old, like really old tale, right?
Yeah, like we're not talking about the Disney Channel movie with The Rock. Oh, that's Race to Witch Mountain.
Yeah, I know. That's what I think. This had Brendan Fraser in it, I do believe.
Well, all I think of is that one. But then what is the one with Will Ferrell? Thinking of Encino Man. Can you hear me?
What's the one with who?
Will Ferrell.
That is
where he goes.
Land of the Lost.
Okay, and that's what I think of too. Not just Journey to the Center of the Earth, Land of the Lost.
Oh,
yeah. I don't know. Could you imagine?
That'd be crazy.
Like if it was like even Ice Age hit it with Dawn of the Dinosaurs, where they broke through the crust and boom, there's a whole other planet down there with other animals, pretty much.
None of us are rich enough to ever get to go, so we don't have to worry about it.
It was like ice on top and then like jungle on the bottom.
There's that new Disney movie called Strange World.
Same concept.
That one, I like that movie a lot.
It was so nice.
Maybe that's where crackheads really come from.
From the center of
from the cracks of the earth.
Maybe they've just escaped. That's
funny. Possibility. I think they're made. That's sad. I seen one in St. Louis.
A crackhead.
Yeah, like on something. Like I would hope. You never want to assume. Unfortunately, you don't. Like, you see one, but then some people have mental impairments, and you don't want to look at them and just automatically, like, oh, but he was falling asleep, like, by one of the cross rock button things.
Well, he probably wasn't on crack.
Yeah.
He'd have been wide awake for that.
Maybe he was just tired and itchy.
He was still tired and itchy.
Just anytime you're tired and itchy, people just assume you're on crack. What the hell?
Joe, he was nodding off in the middle of the street. He was nodding.
He probably just worked all day.
He's a hard worker. Joe might have narcolepsy. I don't know.
Ain't that a wild thing? Have you ever known anybody with narcolepsy?
I have a cousin with narcolepsy.
Do you? And does it happen like that?
I have to say that I should. I've never seen it, so maybe she doesn't. Maybe she just says she does.
Oh. Well, I think
allegedly, I have a cousin that's narcoleptic.
I'm pretty sure
she went face first into a bowl of soup one time.
Mm.
Did she?
No.
Oh man.
I was like, that happened to her, and then she just had to come up with an excuse why that happened. She's like, I'm narcoleptic.
I've never witnessed it, only seen it in movies, but I've seen a video, supposedly she was, and she just stopped where she was standing and fell asleep standing up.
Oh, Rat Race, that's Mr. Bean?
No, but it is, Goober. It was one of those videos on the internet you can never believe because you don't know if it's an actual event or an act out of an actual event.
Mm. Well, MTV for a while had that show where they highlighted people who have strange things like that, and one of them was on narcolepsy, like little known diseases and stuff, you know.
Oh,
stuff
was
like
it
that.
True Life?
Yeah, it was.
I loved that show. Yeah, but they did cover narcolepsy one time, and it was this young girl who had it, and legit she would just fall over wherever.
I auditioned for that for Crabs.
True Love.
It got cut.
That's probably for the best. You'd be where you are today if you had a True Life episode about having crabs.
I mean, then he would just have Tom's Crab Shack instead.
Oh, right? Got a nice ring to it there.
The residual checks. 12 cents a year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Crabs.
This is what we do. We just...
Now we're like, all right, STDs, who's had them?
No. Oh. Playing that game, you weirdo.
All right, well, now we know who's had them.
Without telling me.
Oh, man.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, you're too funny. So, there was something I was going to say and I forgot. I don't know. One moment. I'll think about it. Never, ever. I get derailed in the middle of a conversation. I saw something the other day that said, when you forget what you're talking about in a conversation, but you were literally the only one talking. That happens to me far too often than I care to admit, to be honest.
Multiple times a day.
Oh, Lord. Yeah. I just start talking to them. I'm like, what the fuck was I talking about?
To myself.
Yeah. To myself. What'd I say? Oh, yeah. That's funny. Always talking to myself.
Like, I couldn't imagine, like, people that don't have the inner monologue.
Oh, yeah, I can't imagine what that's like. Like, they say people don't have it, but I've never met anyone who told me they didn't.
Like, I couldn't imagine.
I'm assuming everyone here has an inner dialogue going on.
My brain never shuts the fuck up. Like, at all times.
Anybody that says otherwise, I think is full of shit.
Or just, well, they're just healthy.
Well, no, because it's
mentally
like
sound.
Thinking. How do you not think?
There are some people who don't have words. They just see the pictures.
I know a lot of fucking people that act without thinking. But in my mind, I'm like, I mean, they just do it. From what I've seen, they're like, we just do it. Okay, that's pretty nice.
Yeah, that's crazy. I don't know what I would do. I can't even fathom how you think with just pictures. Like, do you get songs stuck in your head?
All the time. It drives me nuts.
But what if you don't have the inner monologue and you claim to be a person that only thinks in photos, like only thinks in pictures? Do they get songs stuck in their head? What, do they just see the lyrics flash by? Like, that keeps me up at night. Oh. How does that work for those people?
It's just the video.
Yeah,
that's just what the video. Oh, it's the fucking pop-up video, VH1.
Well, I mean, if you think about it, when you sing a song, you're probably picturing the singer in your head.
Nope, just a blank slate up there for me. Not it's just me. Words in the dark room.
It's Thriller over and over for me.
Yeah, like you're seeing it too, are you not? Like, yeah, it's in your head. All of it.
There's not always pictures in my brain whenever I'm thinking. Are there in yours?
Trees.
Just trees.
Fucked up as that
like
is.
You're driving trees. Down well, a road, thinking, trees.
And it's just like, trees.
Interesting.
Maybe that's kind of off my the happy wall. Place. So when I'm thinking, I'm like, ooh, maybe.
She's just staring at her air freshener. It's just one of those. She's like, trees.
Air freshener.
The little trees.
I don't know. That
hang
that,
from
I'm
the.
Sorry.
Oh. What the heck?
Like.
They call it, if you have a bunch of them, they call it a felony forest because you know you're hiding the smell of weed in there.
Oh, I never heard that before. That's funny.
Oh, shit. The smell of weed.
Yeah.
So you guys know my sister works. At a, you know, a pot shop.
A dispensary.
She takes it very seriously.
Yeah.
Like, well, I borrowed one of her purses and I went walking into the doctor's office and I'm like, what the fuck?
Has there been a skunk in here?
And I'm like, is it just the leather smell? No, no.
What was in that purse, Joe?
It, nothing. It just smelled like just it from being at work.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, God.
Yeah, everybody got a laugh out of it. But then I'm like, man.
That's so great.
I don't mind, but I mind.
Yeah, somebody's going to try to call you out on that if they smell it too, you know?
Call me out on what? Legal substances?
True. That's how you make
it. It's legal?
It still feels illegal for sure.
It feels illegal as fuck.
It does. It feels like you're doing a real life drug deal. Mm. I mean, it technically is.
What do you mean?
I don't know. I've never gone into a store and done a drug deal. I don't know what you're talking about.
I've never been asked for my ID during a drug deal.
If they ask for your ID, you gotta be like, you're definitely a cop. You know you gotta tell me, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I had some stuff in an elevator, like in the early 2000s. It was in two bags in my pocket, and then we get in the elevator, and it just stinks up the whole elevator. And I was, it was pretty embarrassing.
Oh. The first time we ever went to the underground, we went down there for my birthday. It was also the grand opening.
Yeah.
And it's funny because before we went there, I got super, super stoned. And I was like, all right, it's going to be me and Tiffany and two of our friends down there. I'm going to go down there, just find a spot in the corner, chill out. Everything's going to be cool and mellow. And I get there, and then one of my friends from work is there, and I'm like, oh, okay, he's here. He told me he might stop by. That's cool. And then another person from work shows up, and then another, and then eventually all of our friends are there, but I'm so stoned that now I'm like, oh, no, and I'm panicking in my head, and I'm like, what do I do? Because these are all people from work. Like, I don't necessarily
and
want them to
know. And you're the boss.
And I'm the boss.
So that's like, a little awkward.
Oh, no. So, and then we get there, and one of my buddies, it's being my birthday, so he hands me a bag of weed, and everybody in there is like, it smells like weed in here, and I'm just like, well, there's a grow supply place upstairs.
Gotta
try it's just me the whole time.
Oh, that's great. Blunt man. You gotta talk in the microphone.
Blunt man.
That's yes. Right. That sticker! Joe, you made that sticker! That was so good!
I'm like, I'm going to have to subscribe to that damn app so I can get, like, the full thing of it.
Oh,
what app is it?
Well, I was trying to figure out a way to put him on the...
I was
working on making a new thing and sticking him on it somewhere.
That is a great idea. Right there in the middle.
Yeah.
What, like... Tune Me. It's just one of them AI apps that Tiffany freaking loves, you know?
That's the best. I mean, they're cool.
They're cool. They're fun to play with. They're scary. Another one. If I can find it, I'm going to pass it down because I was like, because I was trying to make one kind of rainbowy and colorful and neon-y to match ours. But then this one, I'm like, look like we work for him.
That's so funny.
Fantastic.
He'd be looking like a whole pimp right there. Yeah. That's so funny.
You got to send me that. That's going to be my new profile.
That's actually really cool, though. I do like it. But that is too funny.
All of like the one, they kept trying to turn him into a lady.
Oh.
Ah!
Giving him really pretty. Yeah. It was like that one. It was giving him really pretty eyes, and it was taking his beard but turning into like someone's hair sitting on his ear.
Oh, that's funny.
Very cute, but I knew it wouldn't have been cow approved.
Oh, gosh. Funny.
No, I loved that blunt man thing. That was awesome.
I agree. That's my next tattoo.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just going to get Kyle as Blunt Man tattooed on me.
We should all get matching Kyle as Blunt Man tattoos.
Yes.
I'm going to get mine on my left cheek.
There you go. Which cheek? This or the butt?
Oh, down here? Yeah, it's a big tattoo. It's the butt.
Little tramp stamp of Kyle.
Ooh, I can cover up my other one.
There you go. Oh, you heard it here first. Julie has a tramp stamp.
She's a tramp.
Tom, you got a tramp stamp too?
Well, I am the co-town tramp.
Yes, you are. You sure are.
You don't have one, do you?
Me?
No. I'm not. You know, I don't know if a lot of us under, I mean...
You better watch your words there, girl.
Well, no, because not that much, because my sister's 3 years than me, and she got them, and that's, like, when they were popular.
Yeah.
So, like, everyone I feel like that's, like, above 35 has one.
Oh, I have the male version. Y'all got one.
They were cool. Why wouldn't you?
Just like barbed wire tattoo?
I have the male version of the tramp stamp, the tribal.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Gosh, when we first got together, I gave him so much shit about that douchebag tribal tattoo on his arm.
What is it? Is it just a tribal tattoo?
Yeah, it's just some fucking bullshit.
I was literally, I was like 17 years old.
You got any nautical stars over there?
I don't. Hey, I was pretty emo and I thought about it multiple times.
Nautical stars and sparrows, but then only God can judge me.
Every girl in our range, if they're like, if you got a tattoo on your forearm, hold your hand up.
Aw, man.
Every, like, you got one there on your wrist now, but then it went through a phase where bitches were like, I gotta go get a tattoo on my forearm right there.
It just looks, I've got one on my forearm.
I love them.
Forearms and thighs. Forearms and thighs.
Well, like, in my dream, it's like, it was just this arm. Like, that's all I was gonna get tattoos on. And then, man, like, I sat for 4 hours for that one, my first one. Why the hell did I put myself through that? That was when I was 21, and I just got my second one on my ankle.
Big past birthday.
Yeah, for your first one,
yeah.
Right there on your little,
I started small. I started with this little tribal heart that's on my foot that I drew, and it was a free tattoo, and then I didn't get any other, and that was when I, fresh out of high school, and I didn't get any other ones until I got the fox and the cactus on my arm, and that was just a couple of years ago as well. So, yeah. What the fuck? Why'd we wait so long between tattoos? Because we're poor. That's why. That's why it was.
Well,
on my foot was free. On my arm was free. This one here, I paid for. This is the only one I paid for.
I didn't pay for mine.
You didn't? You little freeloader. Look at you. What'd you do for that tattoo? Who'd you do for that tattoo?
My brother-in-law bought it for me.
Oh, sure.
Because I was turning 21.
Oh, a little birthday present. Yeah. That's sweet.
He's a good guy.
Yeah? That's nice. We're just going to gloss over tattoos there with you, bud.
No, that's, I was thinking about how bad mine was and why I didn't get another one.
You only got
like
one?
20 years.
Oh. Okay.
No. I had a little one on my arm, like a John Lennon thing, and then I got that giant thing on my leg that I traded for Ozfest tickets in like 2000, the year 2000.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
But that's a fun story.
No, it was a terrible story.
Yeah?
I would, like, they always say, oh, it doesn't hurt. Like, that hurt, like, fuck. That was terrible. There's the one spot in between, like, the calf muscles there. Yeah. Every time I'd hit it, my whole body would twitch.
Oh, my God.
It was terrible. Oh, God, it was awful.
How long did that tattoo take on your leg?
3.5 hours. Really wasn't that bad.
That's not bad at all.
4 hours for that. And I'm like, well, my whole calf was 3.5.
Dang. Yeah, that person was quick. Yeah. I think the one on this arm, I think that took several hours over there with a...
Oh, yeah, I don't know.
I couldn't tell you. Well, I have no concept of time whatsoever.
I think they let tweakers run tattoo shops a little more back then. I think
that's why it was so quick. He was like, zip, zap, zip, done.
That's why it hurt, because he was going fast as fuck, boy. What, I seen that on an Ink Master episode where a dude was just scribbling on this girl, scribbling on her, and like one of the super, you know, the guy, big honchos, comes over and he's like, well, no wonder she wants to quit, dude.
Aww.
Like, he had her swollen up because he was just digging that needle in there.
Ooh.
I couldn't imagine.
Terrible. I can't imagine getting a tattoo from somebody heavy-handed like that. Yeah.
Well, he wanted to win. Drive to win and get his tattoo done, and it'd be beautiful.
Lame.
Yeah. That's so lame.
Sorry. Fine.
Screwed herself because she didn't finish the tattoo.
Well, that's what happens.
And then he showed he was an asshole that didn't look out for his client first.
Are you a reality TV kind of person, Joe?
Yeah.
I love trash TV.
Yeah.
We talked about this. You love those K-dramas, right?
Well, yeah, but those aren't reality TV.
Oh,
those are like
they're scripted,
soapy.
They're like
stories.
Quote unquote.
Yeah.
No, it's all it's all scripted. None of it's really real.
True. None of it's reality. That's true.
What up?
Scripted. But what? You're saying reality shows are all scripted, so all fake?
There's all,
Oh, yeah.
And then, of course, they edit them to make certain people look like shit. They got to find their villain, and then they edit it until they actually look like the villain.
But dude, like, when I think of it, I'm like, back in the day, like, Flavor Flav.
Oh, I used to love that show. Flavor of Love.
Bad Girls Club. Like, they talk about them now, but all I will always remember is, I think, the first season with that bitch that comes out with the pans, and she like, I ain't gonna fuck with y'all. Yes! I'm gonna fuck with that. Like, that will timelessly be in my mind forever.
Absolutely.
Because I've been there. I got siblings, so I've been there.
Yes. Julie, are you a trash TV person?
I used to be. Not anymore. Yeah. I don't get the remote.
What's your jam now?
Usually my phone playing Candy Crush.
Candy Crush.
Investigative murder shows is what she watches a lot of.
When he's not home, that's my guilty pleasure. Or HGTV.
I love it. So Lex at work, she's been listening to a lot of true crime podcasts, but she listens to them on YouTube. So, you know, that's like the makeup and murder and stuff like that. You know, people doing shit while they're telling you these stories.
You're talking about Bailey Sarian, and she is a fucking
actually,
goddess.
No, I'm I'm talking about that genre
just
of stuff.
Other ones that
but
do
she
it, yeah.
has watched so many of them that she has ran out of things to watch. So now she's like in a different realm of it where it's just like the most ridiculous people doing these stories. And I'm like, haven't we heard this before? And she's like, no, this is a different same story, different person, you know? Only so many murders you can cover, I guess.
Presentation matters.
It
in
does.
Everything.
Yes.
So it sounds different.
But it's every day now we're listening to murder. It's like flowers and murder. It's lovely. Really puts you in the mood to get crafty. Oh, gosh. You know, people who listen to true crime when they go to bed, are you that person?
I don't listen to anything.
Oh, yeah? No.
That is true.
Aw, snap.
It's not wrong.
That's too funny. No, but there's people out there who like to listen to true crime podcasts as they fall asleep. Don't you think that's got to fuck with them?
Yeah,
that's like giving yourself like subliminal messaging
shit. It's just fine.
YouTube. So technically, Joe, I guess.
Once again, sorry, YouTube. Send me to rehab. I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah.
But they have little horror story shorts where people make the cheesiest, horriblest cartoons to go with them.
Yeah.
I will. Those are like my bedtime stories.
Bedtime.
I will pass out before my partner, and he's like, don't put those on. I can't help it. It's just their mellow tone when they're talking. They got these horrible little cartoons to watch with it. And every single one of them goes with music.
I imagine you must be a psychopath because to listen to that and you're like, oh, murder's so comforting. It just lulls me to sleep.
Well, not these like, aren't, a lot of them aren't necessarily murder. They're more like creepy, like someone hiding in your house for 2 months.
Mm. That shit's cool as shit. You guys
is
haven't.
Is that shit cool as shit?
I mean, it wouldn't be cool to happen to me, but I do love that type of entertainment.
I love when it happens to somebody else.
I do, and they tell me a story about it. I love that shit.
Does that instigate like weird dreams when you fall
no,
asleep?
No, I don't dream. I mean, I may be a fucking psychopath.
Some of the weirdest dreams I ever had was falling asleep watching Antiques Roadshow.
Oh,
background noise.
That is another good one.
Oh, that is a good one. I love that. I imagine though, if you're the type of person that falls asleep listening to murder, you gotta want to murder people, right?
No.
Come on, it's like, you know, you can fall asleep listening to like Bumble? No. What's that teaches you new languages?
I think
Babbel. So if you like fall asleep listening to like learning another language, you can learn that shit in your sleep.
I don't,
because it's subliminal. Yeah, it's like subliminal messaging.
Well, I have watched a lot of gay dramas, my love, and I cannot speak Korean. I don't
that you know of. Just wait. One day you're going to get hit in the head real hard. Wake up. Speak Korean fluently.
I try. I pay attention really hard.
Like, I hit myself real hard.
But
I
acknowledge. I got to have a teacher because I don't understand their function of how their language is set up.
Yeah.
And their syllables are separated.
Yeah. You know, English is the hardest language to learn.
And I think that's probably why for some of us, it's really hard for us to learn other languages besides English.
Mm. Maybe that's just what people who only speak English say because they're jackass.
Like, I think Tiffany does well.
Super dumb.
I'm just kidding.
You did well with Spanish.
I did.
So, but whenever I speak Spanish, I speak exactly like
that the honky they make fun of when they talk. And I'm like,
she's like, it's no bueno.
Oh, yeah. I'm like still in the thing. I'm like, can I get my queso? I'm like, God, whoa, it's not that. Stop it.
Queso.
¿Cómo estás?
Oh, you're so
then
funny.
They're like, queso for the gringo.
Right. Queso dillas.
I went to a Mexican restaurant with one of my buddies, and he goes, hey, you guys got nachos bel grande?
Oh, no.
I'm like, dude, you can't do that.
Did you throw him out the door?
Yeah.
Get out of here. Making me look bad.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back after a word from our sponsors.
Thank you to BetterHelp for sponsoring this episode. BetterHelp is the world's largest therapy service, and it's 100% online. With BetterHelp, you can tap into networks of over 30,000 licensed and experienced therapists who can help you with a wide range of issues. To get started, you just answer a few questions about your needs and preferences in therapy. That way, BetterHelp can match you with the right therapist from their network. Then you can talk to your therapist however you feel comfortable, whether it is via text, chat, phone, or video call. You can message your therapist at any time and schedule live sessions when it is convenient for you. If your therapist isn't the right fit for any reason, you can switch to a therapist at no additional charge. With BetterHelp, you get the same professionalism and quality you expect from an in-office therapist, but with a therapist who is custom-picked for you, more scheduling flexibility, and at a more affordable price. Get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/thebarn. That's BetterHelp.com/thebarn.
This episode is brought to you by Copper Fox Contrived, located at 361 West Main Street, Park Hills, Missouri. Handmade gifts and wood flowers.
I've also never been in a fight. I've always been big enough to be intimidating that I could just like talk some shit and I could get myself out of fights.
That's how it's been for the most part.
My thing is, the older I get now, every once in a while I'm like, I need to fight a motherfucker just to prove that I still got it. But honestly, I don't know that I ever had it.
I know. I think the same thing. I'd get my ass kicked. I'm old.
I think it just goes to show, if you honestly see me fighting somebody, there is damn good justification on my end.
Oh, absolutely.
I've never had to bring blows before.
Right. And if you beaten somebody's ass, they probably deserved it.
Something probably happened, yeah.
You know what I hate?
I'll beat that bitch's ass,
bitch.
Yeah, but I'm like a nice person, so why the hell would I even fight with anybody anyway?
I love those bitches.
I mean, they're entertaining because they're a train wreck, but they're just fucking annoying. It's like, okay, go be trash somewhere else. I just hate those bitches that are like, I'm a bad bitch and I'll fucking beat a bitch's ass. Like, okay, cool. Why are you telling us this?
Bad bitches don't gotta tell people they bad bitches.
Right? Like, just do your thing, I guess. If something happens, go for it, I guess. But you ain't gotta tell everybody first. Shit.
I'm a bad bitch. I don't need your shit.
Lord. All right.
Julie, I know you've been in some fights.
You ever beat a bitch's ass, Julie? I bet you that bitch in the streets, huh?
I've been in one fight.
Ooh, I did not see that coming.
It was over a boy, of course.
Oh, them fucking boys.
I was in the all-night skate. You know,
yeah?
Because that's cool, right?
Lean forward a little.
Oh, sorry. And so he broke up with me. I guess, you know, I didn't.
We don't need any of that.
Oh, that's true. It just sets the mood.
All right, sorry, Julie. Beating a bitch's ass.
Well, no, I wasn't. I was.
Oh, you're
like,
getting your ass beat?
No, I was in a bad mood. This boy broke up with me. And so this girl's like, what's wrong? And I seen her talking with him earlier. I'm like, you know what's up. Well, she got somebody else. She got someone else to come after me. So that was it.
Coward shit.
Right. So that was it.
Was she the one?
I'm not a fighter. Huh?
You look like a lover.
Yeah, kind of. For a little bit.
For a little. Was she the one that started the shit?
I just mouthed off whenever I said, you know, what's wrong.
Oh.
She was acting, you know, one of those fake sympathetic people.
Oh.
So,
mm-hmm.
So I wasn't down for that.
How old were you?
16.
I'm just curious.
She's like 35. Oh, I will beat a bitch's ass.
I'm glad you didn't say like 47 or something. You didn't even tell me about that. They still have all night skates. Why'd you go to the all night skate without me?
I should do that.
Dude, that would be so fun. I miss going to Roller Zone.
Yeah, I miss going and skating for the 12 minutes and then just chilling.
Yes. Yes. Who skated? I did a little, you know, when I get bored and I wanted to fall asleep, because you guys know me, I fall asleep.
You
everywhere.
May have narcolepsy.
You know, I was going to say something earlier, but I think I dozed off.
I don't think weed naps are narcolepsy.
What are you talking about?
What? This is the show where everybody gets to know us a little more personally. People who know you, they're like, oh, what good people they are. I mean, you're still good people if you smoke weed, just to let you know, but still, you know. I'm sure there are people who've listened that know me and know Kyle and didn't think or didn't assume, I guess, that we smoke
weed. Whoa, you know what? I don't smoke weed.
You literally just smoked weed right now. Why are you lying?
Do you drink alcohol?
No.
Never.
Right. Oh. Straight laced.
I'm like, yeah. I'm like, why'd you say yes to that so quick?
Yeah, no, neither.
No, he does. Both.
Neither.
It's so funny because when, like, in the beginning of our relationship, Kyle was not a drinker. And he
or
also,
smoker.
He had never, actually, never in his life had he smoked weed.
Pause.
Yeah.
Do you two feel comfortable talking about this?
What? About what?
Weed.
Oh, God.
Like that?
Yeah, I don't
know. Okay, I'll make sure.
What's weed?
You can edit that out. I just was making
sure. Never heard of her.
Never heard of her. That's so funny. But yeah, he had never used marijuana before me.
And then I was like, well, I'm going to hang out with this bitch. I got to be drunk.
Bad influence?
Tippy.
I am bad influence. Am I a bad influence or am I good influence? Because I don't know. I kind of think weed has made you chill out a little.
Oh, were you a bitch?
He was a strong bitch.
He's still a high strung bitch. But,
I was,
you know,
the nicest guy you would ever meet.
He was. What happened?
You don't have weed. And then if you really are.
What?
Nice.
Me?
Yeah.
No. He said, I'm the nicest guy you meet.
I said I was.
True.
I said I was the nicest guy because I wasn't no bitch.
Yeah.
He wasn't in the streets like, I'm the nicest guy you'll ever meet.
Yeah.
So there's something that I do now that I never did before, Tiffany.
Oh, God. What is that?
Fake lashes.
Yes. And that's like a more recent development too.
Yeah,
that's since prom.
Right.
Since February.
Yep. That was
funny.
My first time. What?
No, that was
prom.
In March.
Prom was my first time.
Prom. I love that. Aww. We're all adults. We went to prom. I love it so much.
That was so fun.
It really was. And I think we should do it again.
Absolutely.
Yeah. We should do a different theme though. Like not
sure.
A prom.
Oh, well, I mean, it could still be prom, just a different theme.
New
I just want to wear a dress.
New Year's Eve, that sounds
good. Yeah. That'd be cool.
Yeah.
Rent out the Ashler again.
Yeah.
Oof, that'd be nice.
Who's interested? Anybody?
I'm down. And once again, what another great place.
Yes. Love it.
I'm glad somebody has that building that cares about it and wants to do good stuff with
it. Me too. Jason's really brought that place up, you know? It's really changed a lot.
Absolutely.
It went from, like, people to be like, should I say? Well, everybody knows.
You're in our parking lot.
Yeah, everybody knows. It used to be the All Occasions Hall before Jason Teasley purchased it and rebranded it as the Ashler. But when it was the All Occasions Hall, that name was just not, we didn't associate that with good things. You know, like when I thought about that place, I never thought, oh my gosh, that's a very nice place that I would like to rent and throw a very nice party, because it just wasn't. It was kind of, ugh. But now that he's revamped it, man, it's fucking beautiful.
Yeah. And also before, it didn't seem like it was part of the cool part of town and didn't seem like it was part of town. And
true.
Jason's turned it around to where it's, you know, it's part of the little group up there.
That's very true. Yeah. It's really, that whole street has really come a long way. Main Street.
That's pretty awesome.
It is. I love it. I love that our whole town collectively has really come up.
Good times.
I love that you lean over and you're like, look like you're going to say something important. And you're just like, good times. You're the cutest.
I'm with you. I think Park Hills has come a long way. We have the coolest main street in the county for my money anyway.
Literally. I agree. 100%. I mean, I may be a little biased because my business is on Main Street, but still. Coolest fucking street around.
Oh, there's just a lot of businesses that there's no other ones like it, like around at all.
True.
Which, you know, I'll sell. Name drop the underground again, but that's, you won't find that anywhere.
That's very true. And I do think that all the business owners on Main Street, like, we're all younger. We're all around the same age. Most of us went to high school together, but I like that everybody is like in the same mindset right now. Like, all of us are like, no, this needs to be a better place for our kids. When before it was just a bunch of old white dudes who were like, no, things need to stay the same forever. And when you're like that, when you don't want anything to change, you don't want things to get, I mean, gentrification, come on, that's really what's happening, you know? But absolutely, when you refuse for that to happen, then you stay in a rundown area. So I'm glad that people have come in with an open mind and they're like, no, change needs to happen for the betterment of our community.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if you're from far away, our area is actually a good place to go vacationing. There's also a lot of hidden gems for camping and
literally
you could go.
Did you see that silo in Bonterre?
Stores, huh?
Did you see the silo in Bonterre?
No.
Dude, there's an Airbnb inside of a silo in Bonterre and it's fucking gorgeous.
Okay, hold on a second. I know exactly what you're talking about.
Okay.
It's not really open to the public.
I know it is. It's Airbnb. Yeah.
Absolutely is.
Yeah.
Oh, but we can't go in it unless we rent it. It's been there forever.
Oh.
It's not open to the public. I can't just
go in. You can't go in a hotel room unless you rent that.
Well, no, I'm just saying. I know exactly what building you're talking about, and it has the saloon open where it would be.
No. I'm not talking about the train depot.
What are you talking about?
A silo. It's like where they store corn on a fucking...
And it's in Bonterre?
Yeah, farm? Like outside of Bonterre. Airbnb on a lake with a view. Like, it's really
beautiful. Well, there you go. You can come stay at the
beautiful
silo Airbnb and then go visit Main Street and Park Hills.
Yeah. And we got all those wineries. Like, we're fucking popping around here. Got all kinds of shit to do.
There were some people in Slaughterhouse a few weeks ago that were staying in the silo, that were in there drinking, and they were walking up and down Park Hills Main Street.
Yeah, see?
I love that.
Perfect example. Bringing people to the area with the cool shit.
The folks that own the silo, every fundraiser that we've put together, they donate like a weekend stay at that silo.
That is awesome. Awesome
people that own that too.
Oh, I love that. Did you see that? There's a hammock place in Park Hills, I believe, like outside of Park Hills. It's an Airbnb as well, but like you can stay in hammocks. They have like the hammock tents and shit.
I got a hammock. If you guys want to sleep there, $10. It's in my backyard.
Hey, that's a cheap deal. Damn, $10.
No, I heard about a hidden gem out in Potosi, but I don't want to tell too many people about it just yet.
Because it's hidden.
Yes, exactly.
Well, what is it? We'll take it out.
It's just a hammock in the middle of the woods.
What? No, you won't take it out.
I know. We'll leave it in.
For $12, I'll let you sleep on the grass.
Well, I was thinking maybe that would be a good adventure place for us all to go.
You didn't tell us what it is.
Yeah.
She's not going to.
Not going to. It's a secret.
It's a hidden gym.
Probably not super hidden, but I don't exactly know the name of it. So there's really no point. But I kind of told you where it was. So you can look for magical, mystical places.
Is it the treehouse?
Shut up.
How funny.
Shut up.
The tree? I haven't heard of that.
It's because you're a loser.
I guess so. Whatever.
Well, I don't know. I just now found out Eureka's got like a Yellowstone Yogi Bear theme park.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Why you fucking know everything?
Oh, Kyle just knows it all.
Yeah.
I just have known that
forever.
Yeah.
It's been there for a long, long,
long time. Well, the costumes do look like they've been there forever. But in my mind, I was like, that's not that far away. I would really like to go do that.
Think about how relevant Yogi Bear is in today's society. That has to have been there for a long
time. Right.
Well,
long time.
Bless their place. It's great. I'm sure it brings in. But then I went to go look at like the cabins they rent out, and there are like the kind of sided cabins, like kind of like the one I think they sent the kids to in the Addams Family. Like in that little building.
Yeah.
But they're like right next to each other.
Oh no.
So in my mind, neighbors? I'm like, oh man. Do you know what's so funny? You talked about the stand-up comedian thing again, or you said whatever. But the other day, whenever you're like, Matt Rife, you know the dude that had like up jaw?
Yeah.
And then he went and got it fixed, and now he looks like he had some Squidward.
Yes.
Chiseled Squidward. And at first I was like, what is she talking about? Because I remember him on Wild and Out. And then it like pulled up his like Google image that you get, and it's like,
he's a beautiful man now.
I don't know, though. Like, it looks so exaggerated. Like, smiley man.
But I wouldn't have realized that he had so much work done had I not seen those photos of him on Wild and Out shared. Because I didn't remember he was from that show until they started sharing it. I was like, fuck, that is that guy.
I'm like, I don't know how much younger he was, though. So I also got masculine because he's an actual man now.
I think he was like 13 or 14 when he started.
What?
We went and watched one of his specials after people were talking about it for like 3 days.
Yeah. Which, I mean, hey.
Really?
I didn't know who it was.
Yeah, I didn't know who he was at all until I saw people going fucking bananas over him.
Which is crazy. Just out of the blue, people are just like, everybody's like, Matt Rife.
But what I watched, it was decently funny. It's not the funniest dude I ever heard, but it was pretty funny.
Because the comedians that aren't taking anything off the table are blowing up big.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. Because that's what comedy is for. Absolutely. I'll say it again. There's no limits on comedy. It's here to make people laugh. So, and if it's like, not for you, then it's not for you. And shut up about it.
Money talk, shit walk. He making money. So what he's saying must be making a hell of a lot of people laugh.
Very true. He's got a large following, so he's doing something right. Got all these biddies on Facebook fawning over him.
Yeah, but that just made me laugh. He does. Handsome Squidward.
That jaw, though.
Yeah.
You know? That, I don't know if you can have that much puberty to get a jaw like that from what he looked like before. Like the teeth, sure, he can go to the dentist, you know?
Which, yeah, props, dude. He made the money. Go do that.
Yeah, like, whatever.
Who wouldn't and who doesn't?
Right? I mean,
like his shit looks real. He ain't like one of the bitches walking around where it's like, honey, why'd you do that?
Speaking of, I started watching a new show, a new trash TV show, by the way, called Secrets and Sisterhood on Hulu. And it's basically another Kardashian show, but they're all Muslim women in America, though. So they're all Americanized and everything. And in one scene, this bitch's ass is like clearly fake. Like clearly that is not your original ass. You were not born with that thing. Just too fucking big, you know? Gross.
Yeah. Yeah, now you can get you some panties on Amazon that'll do it.
True story.
Long BBL.
Yeah. Hips bottom. And everything.
Like, oh, how ridiculous.
Got them on right
Could
now.
You imagine if I just came walking up in and look at you guys, my little flat ass, and all of a sudden I'm like, ba-bow. Hey. I'd get called out so quick. Like, there's no way.
Oh, gosh. I'd love to see it, though. Please buy a pair.
Like, I might have to. Halloween's coming.
That's what I was just thinking. Like, that would be great for Halloween. You could be a Pixar mom. Right?
I would need those to be Mrs. Incredible.
She had a badonk.
Oh, Pixar moms all have badonks.
They do. Why do you think that is? Disney's like, all moms are dead. Pixar's like,
I'm not going to bash on them because when I draw a picture of a girl, it's like, boom, boom, too. Same.
That's true. Say, that's because you're gay. Like, that's how you know. If you only draw pictures of curvy women, that means you do like the curvy women.
Maybe a percentage in there, but not enough to act on. But we did sit in the floor and draw a whole strip club.
Oh,
had a glass table. I wish we still had it. Oh, I don't know if it's, but they were beautiful cutout paper like dolls.
That
strippers.
Was in summer school, right?
No, that was the apartment on.
Oh,
that was summer school, right? No, that was last week. God, they made the cutout.
We were adults.
We were adults, grown adults.
That is that was so funny. Oh my god!
Drank some beers, cut out some strippers.
So funny.
That is so funny. I hate myself. Okay, stop it. That's my catchphrase. I just can't stop. I'm trying to switch it up and like implement a new catchphrase in my brain so I can get rid of that. So funny because I fucking hate that I say that. I just can't stop. So I changed it to like, it's so classic. Hasn't stuck yet, but I prefer that over that's so funny.
That's so not Raven.
I like that one. That's so Raven. That's a good one. That's so not Raven. Lord. That's another one. Lord.
I like that every episode we talk about Tiffany's catchphrases.
It's a thing, man. You just can't get past it. I can't shut the fuck up. No matter how hard I try, okay? It's just a whole thing.
She's our Ralphie.
Who's Ralphie?
Ralphie May.
What's that from a Diary of a Wimpy Kid? Bazanga.
Oh. Yeah.
He comes up with the catchphrase and then he gets the better story and gets on the paper.
I love that.
Oh, what a piece of shit I am.
Right? Why you do that?
Ruined the whole flow.
Everybody else is reaching for their phones, checking.
Right.
Not I.
Me either. Mine's across the room.
I'm only a little addicted to my phone.
Yeah. Right.
If it wasn't for business, I wouldn't be on it.
I
constantly say that, and it's not true.
Yeah, I know.
Sometimes she'd be sharing shit on Facebook. I'm like, when do you have time to even be on Facebook sharing random stuff?
I think that about myself, too.
Sometimes I'm like, shouldn't I be working? And then I put my phone down. You get sucked in, man. Sometimes you just get sucked in. It's funny because Kyle will bitch about me being on my phone, but literally sometimes he'll be like, hey, I'm going to go take a shower, blah, 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 blah. And I'll be like, okay, cool. And then like he'll be looking at his phone, like 30 minutes will go by, and I'll be like, were you going to take a shower? He'd be like, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Sorry, I got sucked in. Sometimes I have to be like, hey, are you sucked in? Like, hey, come back to us. Come back to reality.
No, 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 no. That's because I'm always waiting for this bitch to get off her phone because I'm like, hey, I'm going to go take a shower, expecting her to come with me because we always shower together.
Then why wouldn't you be like, hey, you want to go take a shower with me?
We've been together for 8 years. No. When it's shower time, she should know it's shower time.
Do you shower together, Tom and Julie?
Not that often, really.
No?
Yeah.
Every single shower we take is generally together, which I do find, honestly, really fucking weird, only because nobody that I know showers with their spouse that much. It's just, why? Why do we do that? I mean, I don't understand.
Trying to conserve water.
But honestly, that's like the best time because we have kids, so that's literally the only time when we're like completely alone. And that's when we have our best conversations.
So you're escaping to the shower.
Yeah, we're like, we got to get the fuck out of here. Turn the water on.
We spend a lot of time together. So it's like, I'm going to go take a shower.
That's true.
Whatever. I'll be in there and he'll come sabotage the hot water.
Never do that.
We share it sometimes.
I know. We do.
Gosh.
I'm usually sleeping on the couch.
Or like a chair or like a bean bag or just anywhere that's soft. If it sits, she sleeps. That's too funny. No.
Oh, God. She keeps saying I'm going to stop believing her.
Yeah. If she says it, it's not. Yeah. If she says it, she's like, that's just what she says when it's
she's
not
like,
funny.
I say that, so I'll laugh at myself.
Sometimes I say that to people when things aren't funny, but I also say it when things are funny. So I'm tricking myself now. I don't even know if things are funny anymore because I just always say it.
All of life is funny.
I think it started out as like a way to let people know that like I'm engaged with you. You know, like when I'm talking to you, if you're saying something funny, I want you to know that I've actively heard it. And I'm going to let you know, you know, laughing is fucking so 2003.
The problem is she's so focused on being a good listener that she's not listening at all. She's like,
that is true.
Am I replying enough? Am I taking in what they're saying? Oh, fuck, I'm not, because I'm having this conversation in my head right now.
And then I have to be like, yeah, that's so funny, when I don't even know if it was.
Because we're all used to just LOLing.
I was telling you that my mom died.
Exactly.
And I'm like, that's so funny. And you're like, what? The funeral's Tuesday.
You're an asshole.
No, but LOLing, I do a lot of talk to text, and I have to stop myself from saying out loud just on a regular day, LOL. Just in my, thank God that's not become a catchphrase of mine, because I do, in my head, I'm like, no, you dumb bitch. You don't say LOL out loud.
It used to be.
This is not text.
Along with YOLO.
YOLO! Mm.
Our friend Casey, all of his messages to me start with YOLO.
Yep.
Every single one of them. It's like, oh, YOLO! God. I'm like, bro.
YOLO!
Come on. Everyone. He just texted me, YOLO. And then the next one where he responds also starts with YOLO. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, you do only live once, so.
Maybe that's his way of saying hello.
Yeah, I think it is.
Yes, definitely. Definitely is.
I say yellow.
Yellow. Yellow. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll be talking with Tom and Julie from the Lunch Lady Food Truck.
Thank you to BetterHelp for sponsoring this episode. BetterHelp is the world's largest therapy service, and it's 100% online. With BetterHelp, you can tap into networks of over 30,000 licensed and experienced therapists who can help you with a wide range of issues. To get started, you just answer a few questions about your needs and preferences in therapy. That way, BetterHelp can match you with the right therapist from their network. Then you can talk to your therapist however you feel comfortable, whether it is via text, chat, phone, or video call. You can message your therapist at any time and schedule live sessions when it is convenient for you. If your therapist isn't the right fit for any reason, you can switch to a therapist at no additional charge. With BetterHelp, you get the same professionalism and quality you expect from an in-office therapist,
but with a therapist who is custom picked for you, more scheduling flexibility, and at a more affordable price. Get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/thebarn. That's better, HELP.com/thebarn.
This episode is brought to you by Copper Fox Contrived, located at 361 West Main Street, Park Hills, Missouri. Handmade gifts and wood flowers.
Lifting weights.
Yeah. You know,
getting all
I do feel swole. Pumped. Swole. Oh, yeah.
You stole my word.
Ah, getting swole.
Yeah. The Tippy and Jo Swole Show.
Oh.
That could be a thing if some people go to the gym. I don't want to get swole.
Lord.
I would have wiped my own ass.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Oh, God.
I assume at that point you just have to buy a bidet.
I want him to wipe his own ass, too.
Julie's like, I'm getting sick of it. This is getting a hole.
Look at my pecs. Don't wipe my ass.
He doesn't even work out.
He's just lazy.
I don't work out either.
Oh, gosh.
Just got to reach under, bro.
Mm-hmm.
What are we talking about here? Hey, here's a question for you, though. When you go to the bathroom, are you a stand to wipe person or are you a sit to wipe person? Joe?
Sit.
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 I don't want to answer anymore.
You're so weird. Why would you do that?
I'm a sitter as well because it makes actually, okay,
Kyle needs a bidet. Kyle needs a motherfucking bidet because if he's standing on up, clenching them cheeks back together,
that's
baby,
what I'm
you
doing.
Ain't wiping.
No.
What needs
no,
to
no,
actually
no.
be wiped, honey?
Honey?
Honey.
When the cheeks is spread, okay. You can get to the booty hole.
Okay.
When you
I don't want to reach into the toilet.
Well, don't
what do you
do
mean?
That.
You hike up.
You lean forward
and wipe.
I don't feel like I get as good a wipe.
But some y'all, you can't do that. But then you got to do a little extra work and go I under do. And wipe.
To back. That's a big debate, though, amongst men and women. Apparently, most dudes stand to wipe their ass, which is fucking weird.
Well, you know, they aren't wiping an extra area with it.
I'm going to be honest. I've
would,
never
you know?
Heard that.
I mean, I can't tell a man technically how to wipe his
ever,
own
ever
ass.
Ever, ever heard that.
I'm going to be honest. Sometimes it depends on how tall the stall is. Like, I don't want people to see me wiping my ass.
Oh.
So if my head sticks out, then I'll stay seated.
Like, you got to make eye contact with somebody yeah. while you're wiping your ass.
I just look at him like, bro, I'm trying to like, wipe my ass. Stop
shame.
Looking at me.
Look away.
I'm just jealous that you can shit in public.
Oh, I can't, though. I can't.
He has to find a Lowe's.
I have to go to Lowe's.
Oh, man. That is
Which
a
is
safe
a,
place to go.
It
so
is.
Funny.
Is it a cleanliness thing or is it like a turd burglar
No,
thing?
It's a...
That's for me. It's like, I just don't want somebody knocking on the wall. You're done in there?
Exactly.
Like, no, just let me shit in peace.
Oh, the worst... So, it's a... It's just like, I hate like...
Public
bathrooms, to me, I can't deal. I don't want people to hear me taking a shit.
Yep.
I don't want people to know, like, I just want to do my business, get out of here. But depending on where, like, Lowe's, I worked in Lowe's for so long that it's just like a second home. Ugh. So sometimes we'll be out and I'm like, hey, baby, we're going to have to find a Lowe's real quick.
Seasoned fries. Get you. Them every time. We go somewhere with seasoned fries. He's like, we got to find a Lowe's.
Oh, my God.
There's a trick to that. Put your headphones in. You won't hear it. You won't give a shit that anybody else hears
I
it.
I will, though, because I'm super... The worst thing, like, the guys at work will try to have a conversation with you while you're in the bathroom. I'm like, they're like, Kyle's that you? I'm like, bro, shut the fuck up. I don't want people to know I'm in here.
That's so funny. That happened so much to Kyle that one time he was like, man, I got to get some shitting shoes so that when I'm at work, people don't know it's me taking shit and they won't try to talk to me because they'll be like, whose shoes are those? Yeah,
before I go to the bathroom, I just change into my bathroom shoes. I got potty shoes under my desk.
Kyle's like, I left my damn kids at home. Why can I not even shit at work?
What are you talking about? He's a dad. He doesn't experience that. Come on now.
If there was somebody waiting on me or talking to me while I was trying to shit somewhere in public, I would be just like a game of like a test of wills of who is going to sit there longer. Yeah. I'm not leaving that bathroom until they are gone.
What if they're a bathroom attendant? Mm. Then you're just stuck there until their shift ends.
I have never been in a bathroom attendant.
Yeah, we don't go to fancy. Like,
oh, okay. That's
so I've never shit at a strip club.
You know what's so
that's
funny?
The only place I've ever been with a bathroom attendant.
Do they have bathroom attendants?
Huh? They used to. It's been a very long time.
But wild.
I think they're just making sure you're not jerking off in there, though.
That's
oh,
fair.
That does make sense, though. That does make sense, though. How funny. Wait, speaking
moist
of...
Moist toilet.
Oh, God, no. Oh,
Cloon.
So funny. So, speaking of the underground, by the way, we was down there the other day.
That was an hour and a half ago, but yeah, sure.
Yeah, exactly. But we're talking about bathrooms. So, so, we went to the underground, and I go into the bathroom by myself, and it is empty. And I go in and I go to pee. And sometimes there's a little thunder with the rain and I farted. And it was a loud fart, okay? And then, a couple of seconds later, Julie comes in. And I hear her say something. And I talk to her. And then the person in the stall next to me also talks. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, there's not supposed to be. And then I said out loud to Julie. I was like, yeah, so I didn't know there was another person here. And that girl goes, girl, it's all right. Don't worry about it. And I was like, well, now I'm going to have nightmares about it. But thank you.
You just made her more confident that if I got a 2-1, we tune together. We tune together.
Oh, that was so embarrassing.
I would rather have someone obnoxious talking with me in the bathroom. That would make me more comfortable to actually do my business and get
out. Absolutely. Like,
I gotta wait till somebody uses the hand dryer. I'm like, the noise will cover it. Go, go, go.
I've done that. You've done that. I'm just like, okay.
You gotta wait for the right moment.
I'm like, man, my belly sure is rumbly. I hope somebody comes in and uses the hand dryer soon so I can let this rip.
Hope somebody washes their hands. It's a real toss up in there, huh?
And then people come in and don't wash their hands. I'm like, bro, ain't you gonna wash your hands?
You gotta say it out loud.
But have you ever had anyone open the stall on you before?
Oh, tried to, of course, but usually the stall is locked. But you know what's the worst thing ever? When there's that fucking gap and somebody makes direct eye contact with you and you're like, hello, like, what?
You don't look through the crack, you look under. You fucking look under.
A few years ago, I had this thought. So I worked out on the road and I would go places, but I would only, like, while I was driving, I would only stop at, like, a Love's, a Pilot, or a Flying J because they have bathroom stalls with full doors.
Oh.
And I was like, oh, those are the safe places to go to the bathroom without making eye contact with people through the crack.
That's so fancy.
But then I got to thinking, I was like, what if I just developed a product you kept in your pocket? It like flipped out and covered the crack in the bathroom.
That's it was actually a that bad. Yeah, it's called toilet paper.
You're just hanging toilet paper over.
Toilet paper.
I carried a roll of duct tape around with me for like 3 years.
Just cover it up.
Just leave it there too for everybody else. You're doing a very kind service sealing those crevices.
I had it in my back pocket and I had like the chew. Like the can of
chew. The ring.
Implants. Yeah, the ring there.
That's so funny.
When I make eye contact through the crack, I just stick my eye real close up to it to make it extra awkward. Everything coming out all right in there.
That's definitely the way to go. If somebody's making you feel uncomfortable, you make them feel more uncomfortable. Yeah. This is a game of chicken now, motherfucker.
Taking the stank eye to a whole nother level.
That's gross. Cut it out.
Only had pink eye 8 times.
No. Oh, God. Well, you know what? I'm so glad you guys came in today. I'm so glad you were on the show with us.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, no problem. It's been a great time.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You've been a joy.
Thanks. That's what I'm here for.
You too, Julie. Damn, I forgot you were even here.
Cry.
Listen, next time, no Tom, only Julie.
That's great. That was kind of a plan a few weeks ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, and then she kind of chickened out.
Yeah.
She's a
punk out Patty.
Oh, little punk out Patty over there.
Yeah, but now she knows. Now she knows it's just going to be her sitting around bullshitting with us. Right? So.
All right, cool. It's been a great time. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for listening. Coming to you live from the Barn Studio. Tippy, Joe,
Kyle,
and Tom and Julie.
Thank you very much for having us.
Yeah. Woo-hoo. Peace out. Hey everybody, this is Tippy.
And this is Joe.
And you're listening to the Tippy Jo Show, sponsored by BetterHelp.com/the barn. If it's all right.